Hello and welcome to All Maths Considered. In this short video, we are going to look at the following linear algebra problem. This problem will be concerned with the existence of an eigenvector basis for a certain 2x2 matrix with a parameter. So more specifically, let us say we're given a matrix A, which is a 2x2 matrix, 1, 1, T, 3, where T is a parameter. And the question is, for which values of the parameter T does there exist a basis of R2 consisting of eigenvectors? So let us proceed to the solution. As a first step, let us recall that eigenvalues are solutions of the following equation. Determinant of 1 minus lambda 1, T3 minus lambda is equal to 0. So we need to solve this for lambda. We can calculate this determinant. So either we can do it by direct calculation by just taking 1 minus lambda times 3 minus lambda minus t and calculating that, we would get lambda square minus 4 lambda plus 3 minus t. Or noticing that this characteristic equation can be seen directly from the matrix. If it's a 2x2 matrix, then here we always have the determinant of A. And as a second coefficient here, we always have minus trace of A. Trace is the sum of the entries on the main diagonal. Either way, we can calculate that equation. So this is a quadratic equation, and we need to see when this has a solution. Notice, if it has no solutions, no eigenvalues, then there will be no eigenvectors. So we won't have a basis. So for this to have a solution, we remember that for a quadratic equation to have a solution, so the quadratic equation, lambda square minus 4 lambda plus 3 minus t equal to 0, we need to calculate its discriminant. So the discriminant of an equation lambda square plus p lambda plus q equal to 0 is p square minus 4q. So here the discriminant is p square 16 minus 4 3 minus t, which is the same as 4 plus 4t. That has to be larger or equal to 0. In other words, t has to be larger or equal than minus 1. So if t is larger than minus 1, then the discriminant is larger than 0. So this quadratic equation here will have two solutions, and therefore will have two eigenvalues. And for each eigenvalue, we'll have an eigenvector. They will be linearly independent. So therefore, we will have a basis. So as the answer to this problem, we get that t has to be larger than minus 1. If t is less than minus 1, the quadratic equation does not have the solutions. No eigenvalues, no eigenvectors. Doesn't work. If t is equal to minus 1, that doesn't work either, because we have a double root and therefore only one eigenvalue. Now, if we only have one eigenvalue, the only way we have a basis of eigenvectors with that eigenvalue is that the whole space will have this eigenvalue and the zero vector. So the matrix has to be a diagonal matrix, which it is not. So the only option we have is that t is larger than minus 1, because in that case, this quadratic equation will have two solutions, and for each solution we'll have at least one eigenvector. So we have two eigenvectors, which are clearly linearly independent. They can't be on the same line because they have different eigenvalues, and therefore they will form a basis for R2. So the answer is t is larger than minus 1. And this is how we solve this problem for the existence of an eigenvector basis for a 2x2 matrix with a parameter.